What's up, everybody? It's the Inhuman One here, and today I'm going to introduce you to the Timekeeper in Dead Cells. In this video, we'll be discussing potential theories for her purpose in the overall narrative. So without further ado, let's get started. The Timekeeper is a boss character that watches over the Clock Tower biome. Based on the limited flavor text available to us, it seems that the Timekeeper was a trusted member of the King's Council prior to its downfall. Once the malaise and its mutagenic effects had begun to spread uncontrollably throughout the island, the Timekeeper was granted permission from the King to build this massive structure. In an attempt to halt the malaise dead in its tracks, the Timekeeper erected the Clock Tower and utilized its unique properties to create a perpetual time loop. This effectively created a means to temporarily prevent the inevitable infection and subsequent destruction of the entire island. Unfortunately for the island, however, her efforts were all for naught. Despite her unmatched ability to make precise calculations to the thousandth of 1 second, her strategy had one major flaw. You see, the creation of the time loop was implemented well after the malaise had infected the majority of the population and the flora and fauna of the biomes. Ever meticulous, the Timekeeper logged the number of slain infected as the same day repeated itself. However, each day brought about new challenges, and before long, the Timekeeper's number of confirmed kills reduced significantly. Whittling away at an endless army of undead, alchemical abominations took its toll on the Keeper. However, she remained steadfast in her mission and believed that it was still a better alternative to the alchemist's maniacal experiments. As her strength diminished, so too did her temporal distortion. The Timekeeper is unique in that she is unafflicted by the malaise and has knowledge of the beheaded's true identity. Upon encountering the beheaded in the clock room, she expresses her frustration and determination by exclaiming, "Let's end this." After she is bested in battle, she realizes the inevitable paradox that result from the beheaded reaching the throne room, saying, "This is not going to end well." This statement lends credence to the fact that she is aware that the beheaded is in fact the king himself. As a result, the Timekeeper views the beheaded as an anomaly that can upset the delicate balance and fragile solution that the Clock Tower has put in place. Interestingly enough, the Beheaded's presence on the island and his innate desire to reach the throne room are the very factors that have created the paradox that defines the inescapable time loop in which he finds himself. It's interesting to note that the Timekeeper is the only Keeper who does not meet her demise at the hand of the Beheaded, which begs the question, what would happen if she died? Would that provide an opportunity for the Beheaded to use the knowledge he obtained from his numerous experiences with the alchemist to change the outcome of the island and create the panacea for those who were infected? Only time will tell. And until next time, it's the Inhuman One, signing out.